bred with no respect. What is this? Who are you? Get out of my room.
There's no need for alarm, madam. I'm Dr. Reed, the new surgeon.
Preposterous. Dr. Reed, you say? I don't want some bumbling intern. Where's Dr. Swansea?
Please, calm down, madam. I assure you that I am highly qualified. I'm just back from war duty.
How brave. Threatening an old defenseless woman. You know how long I've been a patient here. You've picked the wrong fight. I'm Harriet Jones.
Harriet Jones? Indeed. I've been meaning to have a chat with you. You know what goes on here better than any other patient, I gather.
Oh, better than any patient, nurse or doctor. I've seen so many vile undertakings.
I heard there have been some despicable goings on. Was there a case of blackmail?
Blackmail? Wait. You're investigating something. This isn't a social call. One of those incompetent cunts slit a poor sod's vein.
You seem to know more about the goings-on here than anyone else. Beware, Miss Jones, in case suspicion should fall on you.
That's it. Blame the old and infirm. I see those little bitches' greedy little eyes. Just waiting for me to pop off, they are.
If I didn't know better, Miss Jones, I'd be inclined to say you enjoy this type of idle gossip.
God's honest truth, Doctor. It's just the way it is here. Most of these bitches would let you freeze to death before getting you a blanket.
I assure you, madam, this is not an investigation into a possible medical error.
Debauchery, then? Nurses Crane, Hawkins, Brannigans, whores, all of them. They can't keep their legs shut. I've seen them scratching slutty sores.
Really? Well, if you have irrefutable proof, I'll not have the staff behaving in such a manner here.
This is your business, Doctor, not mine. Where one of the nurses is cavorting with some man on hospital hours.
Thank you for your time, Miss Jones. You've given me something to go on. See you on the next round. Miss Jones, greet.
Well!
I'll come and visit you. The patients and staff might know something. I'll start my investigation with them. Good evening, Nurse Hawkins.
Good evening, Dr. Reed.
What can you tell me about the strange man visiting one of the nurses during her shift?
Let me guess. You spoke with our old shrew, Harriet Jones. Do not pay attention to her, Doctor. She's full of fanciful tales.
She could have been telling the truth about the mysterious man.
That old witch will end up in hell soon enough. Who cares if a nurse finds some happiness where she can?
No matter how you feel about her, Miss Jones deserves our help.
Who says I don't care for her? Hate is what keeps that old crone alive.
What can you tell me about the strange man? Goodbye, Nurse Hawkins. Good evening, Nurse Brannigan.
Good evening, Doctor.
Do you know if any of the hospital staff have criminal backgrounds?
The people who work here all come from very different backgrounds, Doctor. Just like the patients.
Have you seen a strange man visiting any of the nurses here?
I've never heard of such a thing, Doctor.
Goodbye, nurse. Call me if you need assistance.
Time has lost its effect on me.
Cadogan fellow.
safe.
You're sure you don't come back with me?
Nah, I have to see someone at the hospital.
Be careful. You look so bad they may keep you as a patient.
Fuck 'em. I don't like hospitals. Or doctors.
Well then, when you go back to Whitechapel, you may find this useful.
What is it?
A pass for a free medical exam by the best nurse available. Just read it.
I don't read well, but thank you, I guess.
This man has been savagely attacked and dragged to the floor.
Thank you.
believe I'm doing this. Are you injured, sir?
Help me get out of here. I need to get out.
I'm Dr. Reed, and I'd be glad to help you, but you must calm down first. Please, take a deep breath and tell me your name.
Okay. I'm Oswald Thatcher. Please, I need to get out.
All right, Mr. Thatcher. You're safe now. Do you think you can reach the street by yourself?
Yes, I do.
Good. Now leave this place and enjoy the cool night air. It's quite invigorating. I'm sure you'll feel better if you do.
Thank you. this.
Let's go.
Here's what's left of him. Not a lot to check, but I should anyway. Some voucher for a free checkup in Whitechapel. What is Nurse Crane up to? I really must find her. Good evening, Mr. Cox.
Dr. Reed. Still working at night, I see. I like that.
And why is that?
People who don't sleep at night always seem more alive to me. More interesting, one way or another.
You're lucky to be alive, Mr. Cox. I hope you're starting to take better care of yourself.
This place is full of sickness and decay. How could I get better in such a dump?
Consider yourself lucky that I'm treating all of my patients equally. But don't push your luck.
Don't play the innocent with me. I'm sure you have good reasons to act this way. And also weaknesses that can be exploited.
I'll leave you for now, Mr. Cox. Thelma Howcroft said she was being watched by vampire hunters. Where are they hiding? I should investigate. cannot enter. Good evening, Miss Howcroft. How are you tonight?
I need blood, Doctor. Warm, rich, vibrant blood.
Tell me, Thelma, what do you really know about vampires?
I saw one and he saw me. I watched him hunt and kill. I saw his terrible wounds heal as his victim died. And then I knew I was saved.
You mean you actually saw a vampire? Here in London?
Yes. And it has been the answer to my pain. I must drink and kill to regenerate my decaying body. I am a vampire too.
You have no idea what problems your claim could cause if heard by the wrong people, Miss Howcroft. You must stop this nonsense now.
Why fear the truth? Strange things live in the dark, Dr. Reed. Strange and ancient beings that were here before this island even had a name.
I'll leave you, Mistress of the Dark, to your nocturnal activities.
Time has lost its effect on me.
Fear and disgust.
But the suffering continues.
Good evening, Milton.
Good evening, Doctor. Still trying to save lives.
Tell me why you're extorting money from some of the patients here.
If a patient wants a bed, he'll have to pay me a little fee. That's all.
Where did you get the idea for such an immoral scam?
Funny you should ask. The first time it was from a patient who bribed me to get a bed. It's only then I realized I could make a fortune.
Admit it. Nurse Hawkins is more than your lover. She's also your partner in crime.
Of course she is. How else could I tell which bed is free? I need to know that.
Have you no shame?
Don't you see the city is crumbling down? Today people are ready to pay to get a hospital bed. Tomorrow we may be fighting for food.
I'd like to see your goods.
Wise choice, Dr. Reed. A reliable gun is what everybody needs these days.
Thank you.
hot one fire.
It's locked, all right.
What happened? Who are you?
It's all right, sir. You're safe now.
Oh, a fellow Englishman. Thank you, sir. For a moment, I thought those bloody heathens would kill me.
What are you doing here? This place is not safe.
Yeah, it's a cesspool, but it's mine. I came to collect some overdue rent, but those who still live here have gone completely bonkers.
You're very lucky to be alive.
Yeah, filthy immigrants. Fucking savages, every one of them. And now with this bloody fever, they're just animals.
You can find safety of sorts in Whitechapel. If you're quick and cautious, you'll be able to avoid the savages.
Stop!
This is no place for you, sir.
Weapons ready! We found one!
Opium is one of the main ingredients of Strickland's medication. Never a good move. Good evening, Dr. Strickland.
And good evening to you, Dr. Reed. Can I be of any help?
I located the shop, but it was vandalized, and the owner is missing. All I found was your order.
I was afraid of such bad news. People are so desperate they're ready to burgle a shop for drugs.
That's quite a list you ordered. Opium, sodium hypochlorite. It can't be just headaches you're trying to cure.
This dreadful influenza, of course. I already ran some tests on hopeless cases. Without success, I must admit.
Do you realize you could create a lethal poison without the correct dosage? Then there are the legal ramifications.
Is this not true of any medical substance, Dr. Reed? However, if you would agree to improve it, I'd be glad to accept your help.
As long as you promise to be scrupulous with your experiments, I may try to gather these substances and even help improve upon the mixture.
That's all I'm asking for, Dr. Reed. That's all I'm asking.
Do you need my medical attention, dear colleague?
You don't have to worry about me, Dr. Reed. I am here to assist you, not to be a burden.
I want to know about these secret tests you run, and if they can save people from this epidemic. Speak to me now, Thoreau.
I know I may sound presumptuous, but I'm just following your steps, Dr. Reed. I'm casting away the shadows of ignorance by daring to face them.
Self-confidence is essential in our line of work, my young colleague, but only if tempered with the correct amount of cynicism.
But you never doubt yourself, Dr. Reed. I've read all your articles and books. You performed the most daring research during the war.
You have my support, Dr. Strickland. I know exactly what it feels like to battle an unknown disease with only your mind and force of will to help you.
Thank you, Dr. Reed. You don't know what that means to me.
Goodbye, Dr. Strickland. I can't let Strickland put his patients at risk with opium. Perhaps an adjusted formula will deliver more of a placebo effect. Strickland's project could be dangerous. I have a mind to report him to Dr. Aykroyd. Good evening, Dr. Strickland.
And good evening to you, Dr. Reed. Can I be of any help?
I have managed to improve the mixture by diluting it. Have you ever heard of Sir Joseph Francis Olive, or the placebo effect?
No, I don't think so. Why?
A placebo is a substance or procedure that has no actual physical effect.
You made a placebo of my project. Why?
Research has established that a placebo, as long as the subject believes in the effect, can provoke a positive physiological reaction.
Really? That's fascinating. And you want me to, what, administer the placebo and see what occurs?
Something like that, yes.
Well, I'm a bit surprised, but I trust you, Dr. Reed. Please take the key to my cabinet and put this placebo there for future use.
Goodbye, Dr. Strickland.
You always knew the words to calm the children, Helen. As for me, what a blundering idiot.
I'm all right. Don't waste your time with me.
I will not let you down, my boy.
Good evening, Mr. Fiddick.
Good evening, Dr. Reed. Any news about my operation?
You seem worried about the safety of your family, and it's obviously the reason why your wound troubles you so much.
I cannot give up on my children now. They both need me living.
What about their mother, if I may ask?
She died in 1915 during one of the first Zeppelin raids. We never found her body.
Goodbye for now, Mr. Fiddick. I'll see you later.
You always knew the words to calm the children, Ellen.
Will this shift never end?
At least Strickland can't kill anyone with this formula. It's locked. It's locked. It's locked.
But in the circum...
Good evening, Doctor. How is...
Goodbye, Mrs. Goswick. Good evening, Mr. Goswick. How are you?
I'm okay.
Your medical report says you're not affected by the Spanish flu. What do you think of that, Mortimer?
Does it make me happy? Not in the slightest. If it was up to me, I would have left this place long ago. I know I don't belong here.
And why do you think you don't belong here?
I know the staff have more important things to do than look after me. There's plenty of patients here who need their attention.
I have to go now, sir. But don't hesitate to contact me if you need any help.
Good evening, sir. Doctor.
As for me...
Good evening, Nurse Brannigan.
Good evening, Doctor.
According to the report I read, your unprofessional conduct put a patient in danger, Gwyneth.
That's not true. I know when my patient's life is at risk, and I'm more competent than a lot of doctors that I know. Problem is, I'm a woman.
I don't see what your gender has to do with your abilities, Nurse.
Yes, nurse. Because I'll never be a doctor, no matter what my skills. I could make a decision that could save a life, but oh no, that's unbecoming conduct.
Have you heard of Elizabeth Blackwell? She was the first woman listed on the UK medical register. Change is slow, but it will come. And you will always have my support.
To have the right to study shouldn't be determined by sex, skin, or wealth. That's all I'm saying.
Goodbye, nurse. Call me if you need assistance.
Civilians allowed, sir.
Hey! I'm talking to
it's
you.
One of them!
Yeah.
one of them!
Good place for a stroll.
Last warning! Die, vermin! That leech is fast!
Yeah!
This neighborhood is linked somehow to the kind Lady Ashbury's blackmail. First, let's find this Petrescu fellow.